from Dance with Susan Jack. I am Susan Jack and I am very happy to be with you here today. First of all, my apologies. We've had a very busy couple of weeks. 2 weeks ago, I tried filming this episode. We had a mountain of technical issues with our memory card. So we've had to start brand new with that episode. And then of course, last week we were getting our new roof installed. So we had noise and craziness and barking dogs and it just wasn't suitable for filming. I do hope that you guys are all still doing very well. Just know that I am still thinking of you and I'm still missing you. I'm missing MMMing together in our classes, but at least for right now I can still reach you this way. So for those of you that don't know me, my name is Susan Jack and I am an internationally accredited teacher with the Margaret Morris Method of Dance. If you're brand new, I would suggest going to episode 1 and working from there because this is a progressive dance technique. For those of you that have been doing this already with me, I hope you're enjoying the videos. What to expect from this class. This is a 75 to 90 minute class. We're working from the first 4 levels of the Margaret Morris Method of Dance technique. That's basic, white, yellow, and orange. Most importantly, work at your own pace. If something is a little bit too challenging, feel free to back off. Maybe just do half the movements, whether it's just body and legs, working up to adding in arms, head, breathing, everything else that we're doing. Be very aware of your own surroundings, making sure not to trip or step on anything. And always just being very careful. Nothing should ever hurt that we do in this class together. Nothing should be uncomfortable. If it is, please modify it or eliminate it altogether. So with that, we're gonna get started with the warm-up. So again, just making sure you have some space, and here we go, we'll get started. Okay, we'll start feet first. So just pressing through the ball of the foot. Good, spreading your toes out. I'm working on carpet here, a little bit challenging sometimes, especially when it comes to working through balances. We'll get there later. That's it. So pressing through the ball of the foot. We're going to roll off those toes. Rolling off. That's it. I hope you're all embracing May and everything that comes with that wherever you are in the world. Here in Canada, we've had gorgeous weather, just had a little swing. And then recently, in the last few days, we're back to snow. I'm ready for summer. A little high. Up, release the knees, lift. Good. Relax. Good, we're gonna stretch all the way up. So lifting up. Stretching the arms up, lifting the knee, the leg as high as it can go. Good, wiping back. So stretching through our hamstrings, that's it. Good, we're gonna add in a lunge side to side, pointing that toe. If you wish, you can tap or you can lift, working through the side of your hip. Of course, flexing your knees in between. That's it. Good, changing to lunge side to side. Making sure the knee is in line with the foot. Letting the body reach. Adding in a little shoulder roll there. That's it. Good, keeping the body nice and square. A little faster tempo. Good, coming to the center. So bend, now lift. That's it, bend. And your arms, if they're tired, just on your hips. If they're not, up to the side. So bend and lift. When you're bending, tucking the seat under, and lift. Good. Bringing those feet back together. Just march, march, Shake them out. Good. Rest your feet, shoulders. Just a gentle knee bend in between each one. Big reaching all the way up. Working through the full shoulder. Good, coming forward, small circles, a little faster tempo. Rounding through your upper back. Good, big circles, stretch, stretch. Good, just tapping forward and expanding through the chest. And stretch. Stretch, that's it. Keep going there. Keep going. Wonderful. Keep stretching here until our next song comes on. We're gonna add right and left, so right, together. Left, together. That's it, add the head. Good. We're gonna tap your feet back, one at a time. Right foot back, together. That's it. Back. Good. For your feet, pointing down. And up, down, up. Changing sides, left foot, down, back up. That's it. If you need a chair or a wall, totally fine. Changing side once more, adding a twist. Right foot working, twisting your body to the right. Changing side, same thing to the left. That's it. Good. Adding just ankle and wrist rotations. A little bit of balance happening. Reverse it. Changing sides. And reverse it. Good. A little bit of work for your knees. Feet together. Bend, extend. Bend, that's it. Go to where you're comfortable. No pain. As your arms. Bending at the elbows. Everything bends at the same time. Good. Straight legs. Stretching up. Working the calf muscles. Good, be with your feet. Same bending. Bending and stretch. We're just in an open position now. That's it. And last one here. Stretching up, straight legs, same thing. So warming up those calf muscles from a just slightly different position. Good, feet parallel. Space in between. Two. Keeping tucked here. Stretching up, last time. Wonderful. We're gonna just release those muscles. Just kick and release. Kick and kick. Adding in a gentle twist. We're gonna bring this up a little bit. Coming up and over. High as you can kick now. Stretching through the back of the legs. If you can touch those toes, there you go. Good. And just march. Take a breath in and open. Shoulder bone. Breath in. In and out. Shoulder bone. Step tap to the side. So step tap and tap. Add a twist. Twist. I'm gonna add a swing for my arms. Good, we're gonna stretch up to the right. Here we go, so stretching up to the right. Release, really stretch up to the left, to the right, to the left. Feet together, a breath in, and a breath out. Gentle shoulder roll. One more time like that. In, open, shoulder roll. Last time. Are you warm? Are you ready to go? Ready to do some MMMing? Wonderful. Just give everything a little wiggle. Let's get started. Okay. Okay, so our first exercise that we're starting with today is called hopping variations from the orange level. So last episode we did hopping variations from basic, but now we're going to add on some more things, a little bit more challenging. So we're going to add in some of our arm exercises that we've done already, and I hope that you remember them. Also breathing exercises. Starting from basic. Basic arm. Do you remember this one? Your diamond position, stretching through first, suit plates, and down. So we're going to do that with hopping. So you're hopping with the right foot. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So 2 hops per arm position. We do that 2 times through, and of course you have your head. So you've got right and left and up and down. Same thing, looking left, looking right, looking up and down. That's A. Good so far? B. We're going to change to slow hops. Now you note that I'm just doing this on the spot. I'm actually a little bit limited in my space here, but if you have lots of room at home, please feel free to hop around your room, no problem. Slow hopping, same arm position. So 1 slow hop for a 2 count arm position. The right foot, so you've got step and stretch, step and stretch, or step and hop, step and hop. Head left the second time, to the right, head up, head down. C, do you remember what C is for those of you that know orange that have done MMM? C is going to do a yellow neck rest and upstretch breathing from yellow. So with the right foot, we have 1 slow arm position over 4 hops. The right foot, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and up, 2, 3, 4, and open, 2, 3, 4, and lower, 2, 3, close, 4. Good so far? D is tricky. So here's where we're going to work with the hopping variations. Sorry, not hopping variations, the hopping and rhythms that you've done through basic and white. We're going to change the pattern to the 4 quick hops, 2 slow hops, while doing yellow first arm exercise. So with the right foot leading, you've got quick, 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 quick. Now 1 slow hop, slow hop and clap, and up, 2, 3, 4, now slow. And slow. Good. Remember what I said, if things are a little bit challenging, a little bit tricky, stick with the legs. Get the feet first, always. Makes everything much more easier. So once more, just D. Right foot leads, 4 quick hopping. Quick, 2, 3, 4. 2 slow. 1 and 2. And quick, 2, 3, 4. Slow and slow. Good. Did you catch the timing on that clap? That's the other tricky one in this one. The clap is on beat 7. So you go. Quick, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Quick, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Close, 7 and 8. Wow, right? So all together from the beginning, from A, we've got back to basic arm, quick hopping. Quick, 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 quick. Quick and quick. B, if you remember, same arms, slow hopping. Slow and slow, slow and slow. C, yellow neck rest. We're only doing this 1 time. Right foot, you've got breathing in, 2, 3, 4, and out, and in, and out. Okay, and then D, the tricky one, the 4 quick, 2 slow hopping, right foot, quick, 2, 3, 4. Now slow and slow. Quick, 2, 3, 4, and slow and slow. Good. So I'm going to do this with the music, staying right in the same spot so you can see me. Again, you're welcome to hop and move around your room, your space, your coffee table maybe, your sleeping dogs. I have 2 of them right now. Tired from their walk. Check. Full bellies from lunch. Double check. We're good to go. Let's try this with the music. Okay, ready? So you'll start with the right foot. Head looks right with the diamond arm. Little pause. Ready? Ah, breathe in. B, slow hopping. And 1, and 2, and 3, four, again, head left, right, yellow neck rest. Here we go, quick one, two, three, four, and up. Breathing in, open wide. D, and quick, quick, now slow, slow, and up, and quick, and slow, slow. Good rest. How was that? Shall we try it one more time? Did you get the hang of it? If at all, at any time that you need to hit stop, rewind, go back just for some extra instruction, or to extra practice, you really enjoyed it and you want to do it again, please feel free to do that. So one more time, just like that, let's go. Breathe in, breathe out, little pause, right foot, and breathing in. Head left. Slow hopping. Head right and left and up and down. Head left and right and up. Yellow neck rest. Breathe in. Add the head, breathing out. That's it. And out. Part D, last time. Breathe in. Breathe out. Slow hopping. Breathe in. Good job, rest. Wonderful. You'll notice that we have breathing synchronized with all of our exercises. Very important in MMM. We're learning breath control. We're adding extra oxygen to the muscles that are working. It's very, very important. All right, we are moving on to a walking exercise from basic called foot placing. Foot placement in dance is very important. It's very important that your feet know where they are in relation to each other without you looking at them. Okay, so in this exercise, we're gonna work through the ankle a little bit more. We're gonna be pressing toe to toe together and then pressing at your heel. Okay, and it's not just tap and tap. We wanna be working through the ankle. So working as I fall over. So working the ankle in inward rotation and outer rotation. So inverting and everting your foot, okay? So when I'm doing this, it's not a knee and a hip movement, it's a foot movement, as much as you can. So inverting, pressing in front and hold, everting, pressing at your heel and holding. I'm just gonna go sideways so you can see, pressing at my heel. So I'm pressing at my toe first, pressing at your heel second, okay? We're gonna combine this with some walking steps and a preparation. So with the right foot leading, you have three steps. Right, left, right, prepare. Now my left foot, that's on my toe, ready to take that next step, is gonna do the work. It comes forward, it inverts, presses toe to toe, or at your toe, and then it lifts and presses behind at your heel. Okay, now you can look right now while you're working through this, but once you have it, and once your toes and feet know where they are in relation to each other, try not to look. Okay, that's the whole goal. So again, it's mostly a foot movement. There will be a little bit of work through the knee and hip, but it's not a knee and a hip rotation like that, okay? My left foot is just on all this work, and now it walks, three steps. One, two, three, prepare. Pressing in front and hold, pressing behind and hold, okay? So one, two, three, four, five, hold six, seven, hold eight, one, two, three, four, five, hold six, seven, eight. B, anybody know what B is? No hold position. We go front, back, front, back. One, two, three, hold, press front, back, and one, two, three, four, five, and six, seven, and eight. Shall we try this with the music? Breathing, what am I gonna say? Who knows at home? Lynn, Pam, my gosh, I hope you guys are watching. We're gonna always, always, always breathe in while we're doing the work, breathe out as we're walking, getting set up for it. Okay, so out while you're walking, in while you're working. Let's go with the music. Two, three, walking right. One, two, three, prepare. Press, hold, press, Walking left. One, two, three, prepare. Press and hold. Press and hold. Same thing. One, two, three, prepare. Press, hold, press, hold, and one, two, three, prepare. Press, hold, press. Little rest. We're gonna go right to B. Ready? Right foot again. Here we go. And one, two, three, prepare. Front, back, front, back. And one, two, three, prepare. Front, back, front, back. Breathing out. Breathe in. Again. Good. And rest. Okay, remember how I said that we're a progressive technique? We're going to add on the next level. We're adding on white. So Christine at home, this is for you. So in the white level, we're going to build on B with the single presses, but we're going to stop at the instep. So if I'm walking with my right foot, I've got right, left, right, prepare, front, instep, back, instep, and walk, two, three, prepare, front, instep, back, and instep. Okay, so just be with the music. Let's try moving this one around the room, okay? If that's not comfortable for you, you can absolutely do this on the spot, 100%. I'm gonna move. Here we go. Right foot, here we go. One, two, three, prepare. Front, instep, back, instep. One, two, three, prepare. Are you breathing? Breathing out. Breathing in. Keep going. Good, a little pause. We'll go again. Just wait for the intro. Five, six, seven, right foot. Prepare. Front, instep, back, instep. Two more. Last one. Good. And rest. Good job. Wonderful. All right, yellow, I hear what you're saying. We haven't gotten to do an exercise yet. This one's for you. We're going to do walk and leg swinging, which is partnered with walk and leg circling. So building on what we've learned already from basic and white, building on the swinging and the circling. So I'll stay facing forward to start. You have three steps again and the same preparation. So you have one, two, three, prepare. Arms are in our second position. Your left leg is going to do the work first. Four swings, swinging forward and back and forward and back, swinging through to step on it. One, two, three, prepare, swing, and swing, and swing, and swing. Now, Nora, Emma, Ruby, Alora, the breathing on this one is slightly different. So it still follows the same principles of breathing out while you're walking and in while you're working. But so far, every leg swinging exercise we've done, we breathe out on those fast swings. So this is where it's different. You need to breathe in on those now and focus on work. So again, the pattern, right foot starts. One, breathing out, two, three, and hold. Breathing in now, in, and walk. Two, three, prepare, breathe in. Good. Now again, that second position is a nice strong posture through your upper body so the legs have all this control. We don't want any wobbling here. So nice tall upper body, strong work. Okay, like I said, we partnered this with walk and leg circling. So for those that know it, it's a quicker circle in four beats. Right foot starts, one, two, three. This time on the preparation, my arms come to first position, palms to the floor. I lift my free leg, my left leg at the back, lift, circle, and touch, two beats to come forward, lift, circle, and touch to the back. Again, trying as best as you can to keep your upper body nice and still. We walk with the left foot now. Walk, two, three, prepare. Lift, circle, and touch. Lift, circle, and touch. Again, you only have two beats for each half circle. It's very, very fast. So if that means that you have a smaller range of motion on your circles, that's very fine. What's not okay is to come all the way and cross over your center. You want to stop in line with your center when you're touching, and similar, no crossing behind and twisting, stopping at your center. So 12 o'clock and 6 o'clock is where you have to stop and touch the ground. Can we just try those together without the music? I'll stay on the spot. Okay, so we'll do two of each, and then we'll put it with some music. So the right foot walks first. One, two, like swinging, arms in second. Swing one, two, three, and four, and walk. Two, three, four, breathing in. Two, and three, and four. Leg circling now. Two, three, arms to first. Lift, circle, touch. Lift, circle, touch, and walk. Two, three, to first. Lift, circle, touch. Lift, circle, touch. Well done. We're gonna partner that with some music right now. Let's do four swings, four circles. So left, right, ove with the swinging. Left, right with the leg circling. Here we go. Ready, right foot, here we go. You might have noticed a quick costume change, only because we are still fighting technical monsters that are eating up some of our footage. So we're just reinserting into this class a couple of the exercises that we lost with our filming. Okay, we're going to do a breathing exercise now from the white level called upper and lower thoracic breathing. And then we're going to partner that with the orange level, building on upper and lower thoracic breathing A and B. So we start in white, just getting the principles of this breathing exercise. And then with orange, we add on some arm and leg movements as well. So in this exercise, we're really focusing on regional aspects of your lungs in terms of breathing. So the upper thorax, we're focusing on the top part of your lungs. And in this region, we want to lift and expand our lungs up and let the weight of our breath out help to push the air out of our lungs. And then we focus on the lower thoracic region of your lungs. And here we want to focus on flaring and filling your lungs to the side, pushing against your ribs, and then squeezing with our breath out. So we start with your hands. For white, they're just resting on your chest. You're going to breathe in and lift your hands up. And when you breathe out, you let the weight of your hands help to push the air out. So again, breathing in and breathing out. Okay, so that is upper thoracic breathing. For lower thoracic breathing, you're putting your hands on your ribs at the sides, and you're going to focus on pushing your ribs out to the side with your breath in, leaving your chest nice and still. So breathing in. Now on your breath out, use your hands to squeeze. Try that once more. Breath in. Breath out, squeeze. Okay, so as a breathing exercise, we are using deep breathing. Sometimes when we use our deep breathing, we might get a little dizzy because we're not used to breathing so deeply from day to day in our normal day-to-day activities. So what I say is if you need, you may have a little tiny space in between your feet. Our normal standing position, our feet are together, everything is nice and tight, shoulders are back. However, If you get dizzy with deep breathing, put a little tiny space between your feet, and that's going to help to keep your legs grounded in your pelvis. Okay, just my little trick for you. The other thing I'll say is if you find yourself getting dizzy, is just to back off a little bit on the breathing. Don't breathe as deep, okay? When we're doing this deep breathing, we're getting lots of oxygen into our lungs, maybe into some parts of our lungs where we don't normally get oxygen. So all that extra oxygen to the brain can make us a little dizzy. So, all right, let's try this with music. All set? Here we go. I'll come just a little closer. Just a gentle breath out here. Breath in. Breath out. Good. Hands coming up. Here we are. Breathing in, lifting. Breath out. Let your hands be heavy. Good. Lower. Breath out. Squeeze your hands. Good, again. Breath in, lift. Breath out. Same tuck here. Good. Push against your hands. Squeeze, same tuck. Keep going. Keep those same principles that we just learned in the white level, and we're going to build on that in orange, and we're going to add some beautiful arm movements and then also some leg movements with a deep knee bend. So again, working with your own body, I'm only going to do a gentle half knee bend, but again, really important that we still keep that focus on the upper thorax breathing and the lower thorax breathing. So we start with our tulip position. So taking your reverse diamond, you're going to open your hands, cross them, and then just the fingertips touch. So for A, just the arms, we lift our upper thorax with our breathing into a soft fourth position. Then on our breath out, the heels of our hands lead as we come down and cross through our center. Okay. For our lower thoracic breathing, we keep our heels leading. We're coming low, flaring the ribs to the side. Now the backs of your hands transition to change to lead, passing through that tulip, breathing in, lifting, upper thorax breathing here, and the heels, breath out, letting the chest fall, heels of the hands lead, flaring your ribs, and your breath out, back through your tulip. Okay, now comes the challenging part, because we're going to add in some legs. So you're working the breath, you're working arms, you're working legs, you're working balance, you're working coordination. It's a very difficult exercise. So if you feel at any point that you need to just do parts, whether it's just the breathing back at white or just the breathing and arms, that's completely fine. All right, sorry. Somebody was removed from the dancing space. She's my best and worst helper. Okay, so the legs are similar to yellow neck rest. We start with the right leg lifting, sliding up. With the breath in, coming down, beat two, your foot connects, opening up the back leg as we come through our center. When we have our lower thoracic breathing in, flexing to a deep knee bend, if you can do that, and then coming up, sinking the right heel, left foot is now available. So with the hands, it's one, two, three, four. One, down on two, three, both legs extended. Soft knee bend, deep knee bend if you're comfortable. Three, four, one, left foot, two, three, coming back to the tulip. Okay, so again, you pick the flavor that works for you for today. You could do just the upper and lower thoracic breathing that we just did through white, or you can add A for arms, or B with the legs. So one more time, arms and legs together. Do it with me. Right foot first, breathing in, two, three, four, out, two, three, four, in, and out, two, three, passing through the tulip, lifting left, good, lower thoracic, okay, with the music. So let's do 2A and 2B. All set? Here we go. Just breath in. And a breath out. Once more, breath in. Breath out. Coming to your starting position. Orange A. Breath in. Keeping the same principles from white.
You'll be free. Stood at Lady Liberty's feet.
Again, breath in.
Cause you're leaving for New York City. I've never been, but it sure looks pretty to me.
Adding in the right leg for B. Here we go, lifting up.
Buildings that can scrape the sky. All your dreams lie behind your eyes. Send me a postcard, write me a song. When they all come true, and I'm bruised.
Good, left, same thing, breath in.
Cause you're leaving for New York City. I've never been, but it's your.
Just your hands from white, breath in, breath out. Last one here, breath in, and out. Wonderful, good job. One of my favorite artists, you know at home, Judith and Anne, I hope that you're watching. Julia and the Doogans is the name of that artist. She's one of my all-time favorites. All right, great job. On to the next exercise. The three positions that we've been doing in the last couple weeks, we're gonna put together in white for smooth step. So if you remember, we're gonna work through your first and second positions. So your first position is here, nice and strong. Your second position here, we've already used that a couple times for our walking exercises. But now we're gonna soften those positions. So smoothen them out, not as strong. We're gonna relax and extend into them. Relax and extend into them. And it's like this feeling of you just get into that position, you just get there, oh, and it's time to leave and go on to the other side, okay? That's the feeling. You just reach the position, and then it's time to go. So this is done in a circle. So again, the best you can in your house, if you're working around a coffee table, a sleeping dog, whatever your challenges are, you're working in a circle. Or standing on the spot. You have choices. So we have A, B, C, and then back to A. So traveling in the circle in normal Greek position legs. So with the right foot first, you have two counts for first position. Slowly getting there, one and two. Same thing with the left foot, one and two. And a second position, four counts. One, two, three, and four. We do the same thing again. The left foot leading, a first, one, two, a first, one, two, a second, five, six, seven, eight. Now I'm going to travel into the center of my circle. Again, it's very difficult for me to have a circle in my basement here. It's a very small space, but I'm doing the best that I can. So on B, traveling into the circle, no Greek position legs. I'm going to have straight extended legs and no twist. So first again, straight legs, but I'm up on the toes. If that's comfortable for you, one, two, left, same thing, three, four. Now, a deep knee bend for the second position, as deep as you're comfortable. Five, six, seven, and eight. From here, I want to travel out of my circle, so I swivel. My left foot is in front right away. That's actually my first step. I don't take another step. One, two, stepping right now, three, four. A deep knee bend once more, five, six, seven, and eight. Next, we're going to go back into the circle. using a similar step going that we just used traveling into the center, but now I'm adding in that twist. So straight legs, extended legs with a twist. One, two, left, same thing. Three, four, a deep knee bend. And five, six, seven, eight. Same thing left, one, two, and three, four, deep knee bend, five, six, seven, eight. Traveling back into the center of the circle one more time. Right foot leads, no twist. Extended legs, one, two. This is exactly what we did before. Three, four, deep knee bend, five, six, seven, and eight. Swivel turn, left foot leading out. It's right there when you turn. One, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight. Now, you'll notice I'm not going as deep in my knee bends. Again, I've got restrictions in my knees, and today they're a little bit sore. I've already had the dogs for a walk and done my exercising, so they're a little sore already. If you're able to be just off the ground by a couple inches, that's your goal. But we definitely want to see a difference from A, traveling in the circle, to the deep knee bends, okay? Now, a lot to remember just there. I'm going to break it down a little bit more for you. So anytime you're traveling in the circle, you're in a twisted position, okay? It's your twisted body position. Anytime you're traveling into the center of the circle, no twist. Okay, so circle twist, into the center, straight on. Okay, A, you've got regular Greek position legs. Everything after A, extended legs with deep knee bends. Okay, there's a lot happening, isn't there? Should we try with the music and see what happens? I think we should. That's how we learn best, is just by trial and error. So let's try. So don't go full out. Let's just mark it together first, okay? Nice and slow, this music. Five, six. So just marking it, shorten your strides, just walk through it. So first, so these would be normal Greek position legs. A second, slow, two, three, left, same thing. A first. Really getting that twist. And a second, two, three. Traveling into the circle, extended legs. I'm just walking this through. We're gonna do it one more time. A deep knee bend, slow, two, three. We've got swivel turn. Left foot stays in front. That's it. Two, deep knee bend. One, two. Traveling in the circle, extended legs with a twist. So straight legs. This will be on the ball when we do it the next time through. Two, three, left, same thing. First, so straight legs, and your deep knee bend. Finishing in the center one more time, straight legs. Two, a deep knee bend now. Slow, two, three, swivel turn, left foot's in front. One, two, and three. Deep knee bend now. Slow, two, three. Good. Okay, so a long exercise. These Greek positions are beautiful. They are strong. They are also very leg intensive. So just walking it through to get the pattern first, as we just did. If you need to do that again, that's completely fine. Work within your own body. Let's go with the music. So if you've been holding out, and you can go now. And add in the breathing out. Ready, right foot, normal Greek position legs. First, one, two, three, four. Breath out, you relax and sigh into it. Left, same thing. Good. Traveling into the center, extended legs, breathing in. Swivel turn, left foot's in front. That's it, use your breath. Good, with a twist, traveling in the circle, straight legs, breath in. Good. Left foot, same thing. Really working on that twist. Good, last time coming through the center, straight legs. That's it. Swivel turn, left foot in front. That's it. Well done. Very good job. Okay, now after all that strenuous work on the smooth step from white, I'm going to challenge you with balances. I know, I'm so mean. So we're going to start with yellow, and we're going to do the diamond balance from yellow, and then we're going to build on that and go into the diamond balance from orange. So I'm going to just kind of go slightly in profile for you so you can see. You're going to start with the right leg first. I will say that this is the first time in MMM in a balance that you've seen an elevation, you see lift, okay? So very, very challenging. The surface that you're working on will make an effect on how this balance goes as well. If you have a flat surface, you might be able to stabilize a little bit more through your feet. I'm working on carpet, it changes everything. So work with where you are today and be grateful that you can. So right foot first, we come up to the side of your knee. 1, 2, with your diamond, 1, 2. We extend our arms, and from our diamond, we just open to a first position, palms are facing out, 3, 4. I'm gonna push through my heel and lift, 5, 6. Stepping into that Greek position, arms drop to second position, 7, 8. Hold your weight down on your front foot. Now you do the left, foot to knee, 1, 2. Opening to your first position, 3, 4. Pushing through that supporting leg through your heel, 5, 6. Into the Greek position, 7, 8. So you have that lift. If this is very difficult for you and you prefer to stay flat foot, completely fine. If you like to work along a wall, a cabinet, or countertop, that works as well. So once more, right leg up. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4. Pushing through the heel, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Front heel comes down, stepping into that left leg, lifting up. 1, 2, keeping your twist, 3, 4, pushing through the heel, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good so far? It is challenging, you're absolutely right. Orange, we're moving on. Similar pattern. We're gonna change it just ever so slightly. We start with the reverse diamond. So at your hips, it's your diamond down. And in this diamond down, it's important, if you can make it on your hips, that's great. I've got short little arms, my students know that, my little T-Rex arms. So it's wherever your diamond, backs of your diamonds meet. Strong, strong twist. So you've got 1, 2, I'm going to lift, keep my twist, and open, 3, 4. Now up with the releve, 5, 6, flex your feet, dropping straight down, fingertips come curling in. We're back to that reverse diamond. To go to the next one, I release and swing into the second side. 1, hold 2, lifting up, 3, 4, flexing in, releve, 5, 6, straight down, 7, 8, release, swing into the next side. Okay, let's just try yellow first. We'll reset with the music, then we'll go into orange. So yellow first, diamond first, lift and second. Here we go. I'm gonna see if I can do 4 across. We'll see. 5, 6, 7, and 8. Diamond, open, lift, push through that heel, and second. 2 beats is a long time. And open, push, lift up, second. 1 more each side. And open, push and lift, and second. Good, last one. Now we're going to orange. If you'd like to repeat yellow, you certainly may. So you've got your diamond down for orange, lift to first position, palms up, diamond up, hands roll, back to the diamond down. Release to the other side. 4, here we go. Use your breathing as well. It will help you balance. Breathe in, breathe out. Picking up the right foot, here we go. Breathing in, keep breathing in, lift, twist. And up and down, good. And breathing in, first position, diamond up, lift and down, good. 1 more each side, and lift, diamond up and down. Last one, 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and 8. Well done, good job. Okay, we're gonna shift our focus to some mobility exercises. We're gonna work through arm circling and arm swinging from basic, yellow, and orange. So, for these exercises, you will be in a wide stride so that your knees can be bending side to side. In all of these exercises, we'll go to the right first. You add in a torso twist to the right wall, and again, everybody's twist will be slightly different, so that your left arm will be free to be doing this movement. Okay, for basic, we're gonna start with four circles. Now, if you need to do less than that, for any restrictions that you might have, that's completely fine. If you prefer to do one very slow circle, you can. If you prefer to not do any movement in a shoulder and just circle from your elbow, that's fine as well. So work within your own body. We start in our second position. We tuck your right hand behind your back, flex that right knee, there's that torso twist, and I have four underhanded throws. One, two, three, four. I'm gonna add in a fifth to finish. My back arm comes and joins, stretching out through second variation, back to second position. Same thing to the left, tucking left, right hand does those throws, flexing your knee, twisting your torso. Breath out, two, three, four, breath in, and open. Now, very important to maintain this flexion in your knee the whole time. I don't want to see you coming out of it, so stay, 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 stay. Push off through the heel, squeeze at the top, 3 second. Stay here, two, three, four. Now you can come up, pushing through that knee into your second position. Let's try just basic with the music, and then we'll reset for yellow and orange. All right, starting position. I'd like you to take a breath in here. Breathe in. Ready? Right arm goes. Tuck. Breathe out. Two, three, and four. Breathe in. Good. Left. Good. Again. Are you maintaining that lunge position? So hold it here. That's it. Good. Nicely done. Stop. Relax your leg. Wonderful. Okay. In yellow, we move to an arm swinging position. So it's almost like your arm is a lever. Same standing stride. Feet are apart. Toes are up to the side because we still have the same knee bends. The hands this time come behind your back. We're still going to flex the right knee. Still have that same torso twist. And now your arm is going to swing as a lever. So, swings forward to shoulder height, I open and swing to the back. Now you notice my hand is facing the back wall, and now it's facing the front wall. So it changes each time through your center. So you've got one, and two, three, and four. We push out of that lunge, coming back through your center, change your hands. Left leg, twisting left. One, two, three, four. Circle, head follows, coming back. Same breathing pattern. The head in this one is a little bit challenging. The head is going to be reverse of where the arm is. So looking away from the arm for each of those swings, and then following on that last one, looking away, 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 and then looking up and following. Okay, so again, if you need to because of shoulder to have a flexed arm, that's fine. If you have no problems with your shoulder, you want as straight as possible. So no swinging, bent elbows, strong and straight. So thinking of like a pendulum, that nice strong motion. Okay, with the music. Standing stride, hands behind your back. Use this time, breath in. Ready, here we go. And left arm swings first. Circle. Good. Right arm now. One and two and three and four, five. Add in that breathing if you're not already. Breathing out. Good, last one. Good, nicely done. Shake out your arms. Okay, we have one more. We're gonna combine basic and yellow together. So for orange, we're now doing arm circle and swing. So similar starting position to basic. Oh, poor Libby. Libby's tired. So your feet are out, toes are pointing out, you're in your second position. That same flex knee, same torso twist, right hand tucked, we have swings. We're gonna go 1.5 forward to shoulder height. Now reverse it. 1.5 back, 2 swings. Again, the same head in opposition. 1, 2, I'm gonna deepen this lunge and my hands come to that reverse diamond with a slight body bend. So there'll be a little bit of a break with that, but not long. So it's a diamond, body bend, one is just slightly lower than the other. We go to the left with the right hand. 1.5 forward, 1.5 back, head stays left the whole time. Now it changes with the swings. 1, 2, and deepen that lunge into that body bend. So you want a straight line from your head through your body to your foot. So don't break your line this way. Don't be just like here. Bend. Okay? Shall we try this one with the music? Follow along. If you prefer to do basic or yellow, if those feel better for you, that's fine too. You get to choose. Here we go. Starting position. Toes are open. Breath in. That same torso twist. Ready? Here we go. Breathing out. Swing backwards. 2 swings. 1, 2, and deepen your lunge. Forward and backwards. 2 swings. And 1, 2, deepen. With breathing. Breathe out. Breathe in. Last one. Out. And in. Wonderful. Jump to the white level and do an exercise called trunk circling. So as you can imagine, it's for your trunk, and we're gonna do some circles. So really strong work for your core. I'm gonna show you 2 options to do this exercise. We'll do them both, but you might have a favorite. So you'll have to message me and let me know which one you prefer. So your feet are just a little bit wider than the standing stride. Toes are gonna be forward for this. If you have any back injuries or any restrictions through your back, I would recommend that you do this one seated in the chair, or you don't do the full flexion with your body. When we get going with this with the music, the second time through, we're gonna be doing a full flexion to your maximum, okay? Really stretching and mobilizing through your trunk. As we're learning this though, we're gonna stay a little bit more upright, a little bit more stronger through our core, and do a smaller circle. Okay, so again, feet a little bit wider than hip width apart, toes are forward. We have our circle position up here. So shoulders are down, okay, and not lifted up here, keeping your shoulders down. Your head is gonna stay in this circle frame. It's there for protection, okay? We go to the right first, to the right, slightly forward, to the left, back, right, and forward. From here, I'm just gonna release and clap down. A big stretch, clap up with your diamond, back to your circle. Then we go left. Left, forward, right, back, left, and forward. Clapping down, relax the neck. Clapping up to the diamond and circle. Okay, so don't just clap and circle. Strong, open up to a circle. The breathing on this one is very, very important. We want to breathe out with that circle so we can be free and relaxed. Breathe in when you have that big stretching motion. Okay, so let's try. Breathing out, forward, left, back, right, and forward. Breathe in. Good. To the left. Breathing out, forward, right, back, left, and forward. Breath in. Okay? If you are really flexible and you'd like a more free motion while still working through your trunk, through your core, this is your option. So you go to your maximum flexion. So you've got right, forward, left, back, right, and forward. Staying low, making sure to relax your head, neck, and shoulders. Clapping low, pushing from underneath, from your abdominals, up through your circle, then we go left. Left, forward, right. Stretching back, left, and forward. Clapping low, relaxing that head. Stretching up, head straight. Okay, so while you're doing your circles, your head stays in that arm circle frame, okay? You pick what you like, you pick what's best for you. Here we go. Okay, ready? Take a breath in here. So small movements, we go to the right first. Right, forward, left, back, right, forward. Release and clap. Good, to the left. Let's do one more each way. To the right. Right, forward, left, back, right, forward. Releasing clap. And last time, left. Back, left, and forward. Good, rest, right there. Okay, we are going to shift our focus again, and we are going to go and work through our legs swinging. So this will be basic, this will be orange, and then we'll do yellow, which is lying down on the ground. So again, this is a mobility exercise, so we're really working those muscles in the hips for this one. In orange, we add in a body twist as well. Okay, so your starting position, feet are together. I will warn you that my dogs are getting a little crazy, so hopefully Libby doesn't jump on me, but you know, she's a puppy and still self-isolated. So, our arms open to our second position. Again, a strong upper body, similar to that walk and leg swing we did earlier today. And just the right leg is going to start. So we swing forward and hold, we swing back and hold, and then we do three quick. And one, and two, and three, and we close and rest our arms. We do the same thing with your left. Swing forward, hold, swing back, three quick, and one, two, three, and close. To the back, same thing. Back, hold, forward, hold, quick, one, and two, and three, and close. Same thing left, back, and hold, forward, and hold, quick, one, and two, and three, and close. So you can see I'm struggling, I'm working on my balance here. Working on carpet is really, really difficult for me. But that's my new normal. So, shall we try this with the music? Again, the breathing is going to be slightly different than what we did earlier in the class. Our breath is going to be out on those fast swings. So in on these ones as we're holding that position, and then we're going to use the breath for momentum. Breathing out, 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 and close. Also, if you can think of using the floor as you're passing through, so you're pushing through that floor, pushing through the floor, you will get a higher swing as well. Okay? Shall we give it a try with the music? All set? Here we go. I have to stop saying, are you ready? Because every time I see that, I've got two sets of ears that perk up. Here we go. All set. So again, strong body posture. Breath out. Right leg first. Here we go. Breathing in. Keep breathing in. Now three quick. One, and two, and three. Close. To the left. To the back with the right. And quick. And with the left. Quick. One and two and three. Left leg forward. Quick. Right leg. Breathe in. Nice and tall. And quick. Left leg back. And quick. Right leg back. And quick. And close. Good. Rest. Okay. Moving on to orange. Now we're going to add in a twist. So we want your left leg working first. So we're actually going to twist to the right wall. Okay. Working through that soup plate position, you know. So first position, palms up. Drawing the elbows in. Squeezing. Really working on that back arm between your shoulder blade and your spine. Head will stay looking to the right. So my body will always remain twisted to the front. So your body should always be twisted to me. Okay? Leg is going to be working closest to me as well. So we've got forward and hold, back and hold. Now our three quick. Add one, two, three. My transition, I'm going to swing back. I'm going to rise up, turn, and step. Now my right leg is working. I'm facing the left wall. Forward and hold, back and hold, three quick. One, two, three, four, and one. Two, three, four, one, two, three, four, and one. Two, three, four, one, two, three. Close the leg on this final one. Stay facing here, second set through, we lift the right leg to start. This is strong work for that upper body. You have that really, really strong twist. As we're twisted, really feeling opening that back shoulder, keeping the hands down, let the hip be free. This is really challenging. If you would prefer to do basic once more, that's completely fine. If you're ready to go and you want to give orange a try, that's fine too. I'm hitting play. Here we go. So facing the right wall, left leg's gonna work. Strong twist. Ready? Here we go. Breathing in, breathing out. Good, back to the right, do it four times. Last one here. And we close to finish. Lifting the right leg, breathing in. Four quick. One, two, three. Three quick and a change, sorry. Good, two more, one more each side. Well done. Shake out your arms there. I definitely found that one challenging. It is really, really hard, that twist, working in carpet, working on balance. A very difficult exercise. Now, we're going to bring things to the floor, and we're going to do leg swinging, lying down for yellow, that gets partnered with leg circling. Again, a lot of leg work today, but I think we're up for it. Are you up for it? Good. Okay, so for this exercise, you're going to be lying on your right side so your left leg can start the work first. Now, just make sure that you have space because you're going to be rolling to face the back wall so you can change legs, okay? So, lying on your right side like this, hand is just here. So for leg swinging, actually I'm going to slide down just a little bit. There we go. So for leg swinging, we have four counts to bring your left leg forward. So sliding on the floor, one, two, three, four, as high as you can go. Going back again, this hand's just here for balance. Back through center, one, two, three, four. Now we're going to work in twos. Two forward, two back, together, and you have two beats to roll and face the back wall. And we're going to repeat the same thing with the top leg working. Forward, two, three, and four. Back, two, three. In twos. Two forward, two back, together. Where am I? Here I am. And roll. Okay? So the pattern, you've got four forward, two, three, four. Four back. In twos. Two forward, two back, together, and roll, and then you switch sides. Okay? Don't worry, I'm still here and I will come back. Let's try just this with the music. Lie down on your right side. Left leg works. Five, six, uh-oh, here comes trouble. Breathing in. Two, three, four, and back. Two, in twos. Two forward, two back, together, and roll. Again, lift, top leg, and back. In twos, two forward, two back. Where am I? Together, roll, face me. Try it once more. Breathing in, breathing out. In twos, two forward, two back, together. Roll away from me, last time. Breathing in, breathing out. In twos, two forward, two back, together. Where am I? Here I am. Good job. Nicely done. Okay. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to set up for the leg circling lying down. So same music. We're going to combine a circle with a little bit of a swing. Okay? So same position here. We have your top leg coming forward for four, two, three, four. Lifting up and over, circling behind. We come back, lifting up and over, circling forward, and then two swings, quickly, front, back together, and a quick roll to the back. I'm gonna stay facing here for just one more time to review the pattern. So lifting along the floor, four counts forward. One, two, three, four. Four counts to circle. Five, six, seven, eight. Four counts to circle back. One, two, three, four. Two swings, kick a little higher from where you are. One, back two, together three. Roll quickly on four. Same thing. Lift, two, three, four. Circle up and around, five, six, seven, eight. Lifting forward, circling forward, two, three, four. A higher kick. Five, back six, close seven. Here am I. Here I am. Good. And eight. Shall we try this one with the music? Again, a little bit more challenging. We've got a quicker roll. We're combining the circle with a higher swing extension. Okay, let's try it with the music. Here we go. Okay, again, lying on your right side. We're combining the circle with the swing. Here we go, sliding forward. One, two, circling to the back. Lift and tap. Circle forward. Two quick swings. Swing up, back, together, roll. Lifting forward, circling back. Circling forward. Two swings. One, two, together. Good, again, lift. Circle and touch. Good, circle forward. Two swings. Swing up, back, together. Good, last one, lift. Two, three, four, circle back. Circle forward. Two quick swings. Where am I? Here we are. Good job. Well done. Well done. Okay, we've been finishing our classes with spinal mobility and then a little breathing sequence just to kind of mellow us out. Some breathing exercises from Basic White and Orange. And then just a little stretch. You did it. Job well done today. You got through the whole class. Hopefully it's not too long. Hopefully you enjoyed it. I certainly did. I can feel it. As much as I love MMM, I don't know that MMM loves my knees, but I'm still so happy to be here and be doing this for you. So, spinal mobility, starting our work through our lumbar spine, then work through our thoracic spine. This exercise is in both Basic and White, so it's still important that we do it. Stretch out those muscles. All right, feet together to start. Double push, right and left. Push, shake, right. Singles, breathing out. Again. Tucking under. Releasing back. Singles now. Oh, I can feel that. Good, rotations. Right, left, and singles. Again. Hip lifting. So you're just barely lifting off the ground. And left, singles now. One, two, three, four, and we close. Stepping off to the right, feet are straight. Lock those knees, all upper body working. And lift, singles now. And rounding forward. Oh my goodness, it's still my favorite. Singles now. Rotations, don't move your hips, all upper body working. Add the head here. Singles now, no head. One, two, good. Lateral flexion, down to the right. Use this muscle, hand to warm those muscles. Good, nicely done. Shake that all out. Okay, do you remember that breathing exercise, the breathing sequence? Join me right now. Here we go. Breathing in. White breathing. A. Up through your center. Good. Breathing progression. Second level. Set. yellow neck rest is next. Here we go. Breathing in, stretching through first. Good, opening wide. Good, alternate lung from white, stepping aside. Good, to the left. Feet together. Coming to upper and lower thoracic breathing. We just did this from orange today. Breathing in, lifting up. Change of weight breathing from orange. Two pushes, soft through those knees. Four pushes. Back to the beginning. White breathing A. Here we are.
Why is the earth moving round?
Breathing progression to finish. Just to finish a little bit of a stretch before I let you go, I'd like you to take your right foot behind you, pressing your heel to the floor, linking your fingers, rounding through your upper back, stretching forward. That nice stretch through your shoulder blades, through your heel. If you want more of a stretch, you can flex your knee a little bit more, widen your stride. Good, releasing your arms. Coming up on that back toe, tucking the knee to the floor, tucking the pelvis. You're gonna stretch through your hip flexor a little bit through the quad. Again, if you need to widen the stride, you get a little bit more work in the hip flexor. Good. I hope you enjoyed today's class. I enjoyed being here with you. I hope you're all doing well. Good, I'm just giving that a little shake. If you'd like to bring that up for a quadricep stretch, you certainly may. If you need to hang on to something, you can. We'll see how the balance is doing at this point in the class. So when you're good, think of tucking, strong through your abdominals, keeping your knees aligned. That's it. Good job, just release that shake out. Taking your left foot, same thing. Heel to the floor behind. That stretching your calf, maybe a little bit through your Achilles, opening through your chest, flexing those elbows in, opening up. Option two, you can link your fingers, roll your shoulders, and stretch down. That's it. Good job. Okay, coming up on that back toe, releasing those hands, and widen the stride if you want to. Tuck your pelvis here. You're gonna feel the stretching through the hip flexor, quadricep a little bit. Wonderful. Sliding your feet together. We'll do just a little bit more for the quadricep there. We got a lot of work done today with all those smooth steps with the Greek positions. So staying knee to knee. That's it. Tuck through your abdominals. Try to keep your knees together. That's it. Good job. Just release that down. Stretching through your shoulders, keeping everything pressed down. Here we are. Looking over the right side. Right arm comes across. You feel the stretch in the back of your shoulders. That's it. Good. Same thing on the left side. Left arm comes across. Oh, I really feel it on this side. It's always been my bad side, my guys know from the class. It's where I carry most of my tension, is in my shoulders, through my neck. do hamstring stretch. So feet apart, we're gonna come forward for this. So again, working within your own body, if you feel more comfortable stretching with your feet forward, that's fine too. Coming up first, sitting back on your heels, coming forward, feeling that nice stretch. When you're at your limit, releasing your knees and coming down. Relaxing your head, neck, and shoulders. I can really feel these today. Breathing through the stretches. Walking your hands to the right side. Good. Releasing that. Coming to the left side. Continue your breathing. Your center. I'm just widening my stride a little bit. I'd like to get a little bit of an adductor stretch here. So I'm on my right side, flexing my right knee, feeling that stretch all the way through the left side. Maria, I just checked to make sure my pant legs were still even. We're good. I hope you're doing well. Wonderful. Up through center, flexing the left side. Coming up, bringing your feet together. Just get a little bit of a stretch through your core. A little bit of work today with the white. I'll just go on an angle here. I'd like you to step your right foot forward and just lift and stretch up to the ceiling. Stretch all the way through your front. Sit. Good. Releasing, coming back. Same thing, left side coming forward. Lifting up, stretch. Coming back. Last, just our hips. Pushing your right hip to the wall. You may cross over here. If you've got the flexibility and you want to do the figure four standing, you may. So hip to the side. Stretching through that right side all the way through those obliques up to the ceiling. That's it. Thinking tall. Good. And releasing that. Same thing, left side, pushing your left hip to the wall. I'm gonna cross over for balance, but you can certainly stay here. You can do a standing figure four as well. Add in that side stretch as well, really lengthening through the left side. That's it. Wonderful. Just a breath in. And a breath out. And circle your shoulders. One more. And open. And circle. That's it for today's class. I hope that you enjoyed it. I certainly enjoyed being here with you. I hope that you're still well. I hope that you are still breathing and moving and enjoying MMM. Maybe enjoying some things outside now that things are starting to get a little bit warmer, except for today it's snowing. just know that some days are difficult, other days are fantastic, and trying to have that balance in between the two that are really important. Accepting that there's things that you can't control right now, things that you can't change, but still trying to be your best version of you in the meantime. So, again, tune back in. Come dance with us through the choreography channel. Stretch if you need to through the stretching playlist. And just move and just do MMM with us. And know that when I'm here, when I'm with you, I'm here and I'm with you. I'm thinking of you constantly. I've missed you all. And I cannot wait till we can be together again in person to be doing MMM. Until then, stay safe, stay happy, stay balanced, and stay moving in MMM. Take care, everybody. Bye now.